Hi everyone, my name is Taya and today we will talk about the minimal viable product approach and its benefits. As an entrepreneur, you may eventually come to the point of planning a startup and launching your software product. Initially, you only have the idea of the product. What's next? According to the statistics, the failure rate of the startups is around 90%, and one of the main reasons is the lack of demand in the market. That's why when you have a brilliant idea, do not rush building a fully featured product, but create an MVP instead. This will help you check the feasibility of your product idea. What is a minimal viable product? MVP is a concept from Lean Startup that stresses the impact of learning in new product development. Eric Ries defined an MVP as a version of a new product, which allows a team to collect the maximum amount of validated learning about a customer with the least effort. The MVP will help you avoid building products that nobody wants, maximize learning per dollar spent, get the facts before it's too late. A lot of successful products started with the MVP. For example, Airbnb, Twitter, Uber, YouTube, Instagram, Pinterest, Facebook. These companies started the initial idea with testing and developed their product accordingly. Build, measure, learn. This is another lean startup methodology which will help you on the way. The main points of the build, measure, learn loop are the following. Define whether the product idea solved the user's problem. Quickly manage an action on a program that will test the idea with the users. Obtain feedback from your customers. Make decisions and continue product development or pilot. What are the benefits of a minimum viable product? Get user feedback. With MVP, you can build an app with enough functionality to attract early adopters. As soon as feedback from your pioneer's users is received, you will know where to improve or iterate the product. Therefore, user feedback is a must when building a new product, and this will help you make decisions about the future product development. Save costs. When you build an MVP app, there is no need to implement complex functionality, and some MVPs have only one killer feature. It means that the development team will need less time to complete the project. Consequently, you will have to pay less money for development service. Test a hypothesis. A study by CB Insights found that 42% of new project failures take place because of the lack of market demand. An MVP helps to ensure that there is a demand for a product and to change an unprofitable idea to a timely manner. You should test your key business hypothesis and business ideas with the real users and do it as quickly and cost-effectively as possible. Launch quickly. The market changes quickly, so it's important to test your idea in the shortest time possible. With the MVP approach, you will get viable experience much earlier. For example, you can test marketing strategies and sales channels much earlier and can find the most effective ways to promote the product. Attract investment. Finally, one more of the MVP benefits is that it helps attract investors. According to Forbes, investors need to see that you have initial accomplishments and that there is a customer demand in your product. The company that managed to show the demand for their product will likely get the required funding. The best way to solve this task is to create an MVP with several basic features and wait for customers' feedback. If it is positive, you can freely present it to investors, knowing that your business idea is feasible. To sum it up, building an MVP helps you test your business idea and see if it is reasonable enough to create a fully featured product. Also, it is a wise way to save time and budget. I hope this video was useful. If you have any questions, please share them in the comments. Also, subscribe to Codica channel and don't miss our next video on product development. Thank you for watching, and until next time.